To minimize misconceptions about COVID-19, we must primarily rely on the most recent updated scientific information we have available. Keep in mind, this is a new disease, so research is still ongoing. We have based this report on information from documented scientific studies, the World Health Organization, and Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. COVID-19 is a transmissible disease caused by a newly discovered coronavirus, technically called SARS-CoV-2, but commonly known as the coronavirus. COVID-19 infections are caused by droplet transmissions of the virus. These droplets are produced through sneezing, coughing, and breathing. The droplets usually fall to the ground. However, if you are within a meter of someone else who is coughing or sneezing who also has the virus, you are at risk of having your mouth, nose, and eyes exposed to these infectious droplets. These regions are primarily where the virus enters and proceeds to infect. Additionally, traces of the virus can survive on surfaces for many hours. Symptoms of the coronavirus appear 2 to 14 days after initial exposure. The common symptoms are a dry cough, muscle pains, weakness, tiredness, and fever, which is when your body temperature exceeds 37 degrees Celsius. Less common symptoms are a headache, conjunctivitis, sore throat, diarrhea, loss of smell, and loss of taste. If you suffer from serious symptoms such as difficulty breathing, chest pain, and/or a loss of speech or movement, then you will need urgent medical attention. Many individuals, however, only experience mild symptoms or no symptoms at all. Not realizing they may still have the virus, they may go on to transmit the virus anyway. If you do experience these symptoms, you must follow these measures. In instances of a mild cough or fever, we recommend that you self-isolate. If your fever advances, you should then go to seek medical attention. When accessing health facilities, we recommend that you wear a mask, maintain about a meter's distance from others, avoid making contact with surfaces, and avoid touching your face. Here are some preventative measures you can follow. Wash your hands frequently and thoroughly with soap and water for at least 40 to 60 seconds. If no soap and water is available, you can use alcohol-based hand sanitizer. To wash your hands, wet your hands with water and apply enough soap or sanitary product to cover the entire surface of your hands. Rub hands palm to palm to obtain foam. Then rub your right palm over the back of your left hand with interlaced fingers and vice versa. Rub again palm to palm, but this time with your fingers interlaced. Rub the back of your fingers to opposing palms with fingers interlocked for both hands. Rub your thumb rotationally clasped in the other hand's palm for both thumbs. Clean the tips of your fingers by rubbing them rotationally on the other hand's palms for both hands. Maintain at least a meter's distance from others to avoid catching small infectious droplets. Avoid crowded places as you are likely to encounter someone who has the virus. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth to prevent the virus from entering your body. When you sneeze or cough, cover your mouth and nose with a tissue or your elbow. There is currently no evidence that the coronavirus affects people living with HIV any differently when they are immunologically stable. It is, however, important for people living with HIV to follow the general precautions to limit any risk of coronavirus infection. We also urge people living with HIV who are on antiretroviral therapy to have at least 30 days or up to a 6-month supply of a medication. Make sure your vaccinations are all up to date, specifically your influenza and pneumococcal vaccines. We also recommend that you acquire medicines to treat other related co-infections and addictions. We hope you have found this video resource useful. Please try to follow the recommended safety guidelines and stay up to date with any new information concerning the outbreak. Thank you.